So in this presentation, we look at the skills required in order to put a 90 degree bend in a piece of PVC conduit. We've got two socket outlets screwed to the wall, and we're going to simply have a piece of conduit that runs horizontally along here with a nice 90 degree bend and goes into the other socket outlet. And we're going to look at the skills required in order to put a nice smooth bend into that PVC conduit. A little bit of a recap, we're working with 20 millimeter PVC conduit. They also come 16, 25 and 32. This time we're talking about the diameter of the actual conduit itself, so it isn't millimeters squared. So we're using 20 millimeter PVC conduit. And we've got a lovely smooth bend in it. First of all, we need to work out the length that we need to cut our conduit at. And for this, we're gonna be longer than we need it. So when I take my tape measure, I'm gonna overhang the box and bring it round. And I'm gonna overhang the box this side and come out to about 170 centimeters or 1,700 millimeters. So I'm longer this side and longer that side than I need. And then I'm gonna cut it back once I've put my lovely smooth bend in it. So let's cut the PVC conduit next. So we've got our required measurement of 170 centimeters or 1,700 millimeters. Gonna need to cut the conduit now. Doesn't matter how we cut the end of this stage, because obviously it's longer than we need it. We're gonna end up cutting it back and making sure that end is square and burr free in the future. So at the minute, it's just all about cutting it to the required length. So approximately for me, 170. And we're gonna do this one over our knee. What I don't want to see us doing is taking the conduit into the workshop using the square jaw vices in order to hold it. We do it over our knee, in this case using a junior hacksaw. We're not concerned what the end looks like at this stage. We're obviously going to prepare the end when it's actually at the required length. What we need to do now is put the bend in the appropriate position within the conduit itself. So let's see how we're going to do that. So I'm ready to try and put my 90 degree bend in my PVC conduit, remembering that this end here is slightly shorter than this one here. So we will put the bend slightly more to one side than the other. We're going to use a 20 mil conduit bending spring. The idea of the bending spring is to prevent the conduit from collapsing when we bend it. Equally, you'd need a 16, 25 or 32, depending on the size of conduit you're going to use. The spring needs to be offered up on the outside first in order to work out the position in which you want to start the bend. So slightly more to this end for me than this end, so this will be longer going this way. There's a cable on the outside to prevent it getting trapped inside the conduit. I just fold it over in order that I can drop it in to the conduit itself and position it down there, fold it over. So I've got the spring here in this section of conduit. What I'm going to do next is warm up the conduit to try and prevent that spring from rippling through. I know over the years the conduit isn't as good a grade as it used to be, and it does slightly whiten out the black when you put the bend in. We're going to have to live with that. Take a rag and we're going to warm up the conduit in the section we want to bend. And that should be touch warm, which it is. And then for my technique, I'm going to get onto what I call a large motorbike. So my arms are at that kind of width. We'll be playing around with the width of the arms depending on the student. So mine's about there. Okay, and then from that position, I'm just going to fold it in, hold it, allow it to come out, fold it in, and hold it, and we go out. Finally, again, just hold it in. I want to leave it in a slightly overbend position, so I want to rest it beyond 90 in that position, possibly about there. The spring needs to come out of this stage and it needs to be rested. Need to give it a couple of minutes before we even consider trying to cut it to the required dimensions. So spring comes out and we're going to rest that in a overbent position for a few minutes before we do anything else with it. So I've rested our PVC conduit and we can see our bend now is approximately at 90 degrees. We can just tug it out if we need to, but we can never put more bend in. So if it's gone beyond 90, what we can't do, I'll show you on this one, what we can't do is actually put more bend in without putting the spring back in. Because if we do, it just collapses. So we should have reinserted the bending spring if we wanted to add more bend to the 90 degrees. We can pull it out. So we can just gently tease it out, but we can't put any more in. My cross-reference point is a steel conduit bend, which is done on a conduit bending machine in the former, as whether that is an acceptable bending radius. The bending radius should be 2.5 times the diameter of the pipe as a minimum, which is a 50 mil radius. However, if I offer it up here across the top of the steel conduit, we can see that that's near perfect with the technique we've used to get a bending radius identical to that one in steel. So steel was done using the former. We used our big motorbike technique and we've got a bending radius very similar to that. We're going to see how now we can adapt it in order to fit it between our two boxes. So I'm ready to cut my conduit in order to facilitate between the two boxes. We need to put in some female adapters, so we need to unscrew these and put those in the boxes. Care must be taken that they don't go all the way in. The conduit will not go all the way in, it stops. It's a case of working out how far it will go into your adapter, because you won't be cutting the conduit flush with either box. It will be shorter in both cases. We need to allow for that when we make our cut. So adapters are in. And what I do with this section here is I slide some saddles on the back. We know afterwards they're going to go on in a different technique, but at this stage, this is not obviously how we fit saddles, but we know that from the workshop. I'm just going to slide these on as a little cross reference for me so I can get it running horizontal with the wall. So I'm going to offer these over the top with a couple of temporary saddles on for length, and then I've got to work out where I'm going to cut my pipe at each end, remembering it will not go fully into the adapter, it will be slightly short of fully in, and that's something you've got to work out yourself. And we're going to have to make sure the ends are correct at that stage. So offering that one round, I'm going to make my cut this end, and I'm going to do the same this end. I'm now ready to cut the conduit square and de-ream the ends. So let's see that first. I'll do one end for you. So over my knee again, taking my junior hacksaw, care now to try and get it as square as possible. So I cut my conduit down. Believe it or not, in college we're gonna do this. We're gonna square the ends, we're using a file. Super square. And ream them out so there's none of those plastic little whiskers in there. So we're going to clean it up. Okay, so we've got a nice clean end, nice and square and nice and clean for college, in order that we can push it into the female adapter at both ends. I'll cut the other one and then we'll see what it looks like positioned on the wall. So I've made the necessary adjustments in my conduit that it fits snugly within both adapters and doesn't move backwards and forwards when I'm pushing against it. So I don't want this sliding in and out. It's run horizontally, so it looks good. We've now only got to secure it using the appropriate saddles. As we move towards the 18th edition, we're going to find that the saddles are likely to be metallic, because we do not want the conduit system to collapse in the event of a fire, or at least be held into position for the longest possible time. Currently, we're going to be fitting PVC saddles, but then as we move forward, we're going to find that these are either going to be black metallic as they adapt them, or we'll be using a steel conduit saddle in order to support the conduit system itself. BS7671 says that these saddles should be positioned within 300mm of the box. So from this socket coming out, we must have a saddle within 300mm. Likewise, where there's a bend in the conduit, we must also support it within 300mm. I believe our saddles are probably going to go approximately here, this side of the bend, and equidistant this side of the bend, so it looks nice in order to support the conduit system. So we've used a technique to put a nice smooth 90 degree bend in it, and we've made a few adjusting cuts, squared the ends and reamed them so they can go into the adapters. I hope this video has been some